Hunter, not to, you know, give you guys a built-in excuse or anything, but you had seven guys. How much of a disadvantage did you feel like that put you at?
Yeah, obviously a disadvantage. I mean, no excuses, but yeah, it's definitely tough. Having limited numbers, especially missing Damani. He's a big energy guy for us, so, you know, once we get the whole team back together, it'll be a bit nicer, but yeah, it is what it is.
Mason, how did you feel like you guys battled through that challenge of being shorthanded?
I think we did pretty good for the most part. And we just got to improve on some things, and some of us are sick, so we just got to get over that. So it will be good for next game.
Well, you obviously, you know, haven't had as much time to practice together as a whole unit with guys being in and out. Did it feel like you were kind of rusty early on, that it took a while to kind of get going? Because you haven't played a game since, what, before Christmas?
Yeah. It felt kind of weird in the beginning, but once the ball tips, and it's just back to normal. So it's just what it is.
And Mason, with the short turnaround on Monday, you know, how difficult is that going to be for you guys to just kind of get this one out of your head and move on?
I think we just got to get it past us and just get that one's out of the way. So just next game mentality.
And Hunter, what were you trying to find inside? You know, they've got some good size to them as well. What were you trying to find inside that maybe got you a couple good looks tonight?
Just being more aggressive. Just changed my mentality to kind of score first rather than pass first. And I guess it kind of helped tonight, but yeah.
Would you guys say it was, I mean, you lost, and I know you're not happy about losing the game, but on some level, was it good just to play basketball again, to make out and play another game?
Yeah, it's fun, especially that environment. Yeah, it's cool to play in that environment. Obviously, would have loved to win, but, you know, it's fun to play again, be back to normal.
Be back, yeah. Thought the guys battled through, we had a tough stretch to start the game, and we battled back, and then we had a tough stretch at the end of the first half. But our guys didn't give up and battled through it. And we've had four practices in 16 days, and we had eight available players. And proud of the way the guys competed, even though you're getting against a very good team, obviously. So there are some things we need to work on, clearly. But our guys, they have their high character, and they're going to keep working. And we hopefully get some guys back here soon and have more available bench players and more available players. But State played really well. Shireman was unbelievable, and Mayo was big time tonight. And you can't let those guys get those numbers and expect to win the game.
Was there the kind of rust maybe that you expected to see a little bit just from the lack of practice time and not having played the game in so long?
Yeah, the last game we played was December 22nd, so we expected some rust, and guys aren't in great shape, you know, right now. The first we practiced Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. Monday and Tuesday we're just trying to get their legs under them a little bit, and then Thursday and Friday felt a little bit more like college basketball practices. But yeah, I'm sure there's some rust with the guys. I looked out there and they got their hands on their head, and they're not in great basketball shape. And as you guys know, it's basketball shape is just different. You know, you can't get it in 4 days. You can't get on a treadmill and get it. You have to play basketball and get up and down the court. And our guys aren't in shape right now, and it may not be for, you know, maybe till next week or a week or two until they are in shape with that many days off.
Well, it's 11-0, and you got seven guys. I mean, I think everyone in the building was kind of wondering, here we go. But then you got it back down to three. What did you see during that run from your team to kind of chip way back in and get back in the game?
Well, we settled down, and we got some stops. I mean, there are shots that we gave up that were our fault. But there's other times they just make shots. You know, Shireman, you know, he makes shots. So we settled down. We got some stops, and I didn't feel like they were going to – no, unfortunately, they did keep making shots. But we did a good job of running offense, and we didn't finish – we finished pretty good inside. We didn't get to the foul line. We're fourth in the country in getting to the foul line. We shot four free throws tonight, so that's tough. You know, we get to the line a lot, fourth in the country. Free throw attempts, the field goal attempts, and we just couldn't get there. And we were pounding the ball inside, much like they were. So that was disappointing. And but our guys settled down and started making some shots and finishing around the goal, and we made a good run. But we can't keep doing that. We've done that the last number of games. We've played well in the second half. We just haven't started the games well, and I got to figure out what that is.
What's overall the status of Xavier Fuller and just what he's dealing with right now?
He is dealing with a knee injury, and we don't know when he's going to return. We're kind of up in the air on that. That's a matter of when he gets healthy and is able to play. So right now he is going to be out for a while.
And after dealing with the COVID situation in the last couple of weeks, how is the team kind of progressing through that? Is it kind of run its course, or are you still dealing with some lingering situations there?
Well, we aren't really dealing with any lingering situations, but Damani hasn't practiced in 16 days, so he got cleared today. I didn't feel like it would be in his best interest to put him out in a Division I college basketball game, not practicing for 16 days. So I would have felt awful if he got hurt. I mean, I can't imagine. It didn't matter what the score was, what the circumstance was. I wasn't going to put him out there. He hadn't even practiced. So that's really it, because everybody else is healthy through that. Okay. Now we've got a couple injuries. We'll get Damani back. He'll have a practice tomorrow, and then we play on Monday, so maybe he can start getting back there. But we still have a couple injuries, but the COVID part of it is pretty much done right now.
How do you feel Eric and Boogie kind of filled in for Xavier in his absence?
I thought Boogie played well. He ended up with 10 points. He did have 4 turnovers, missed a couple shots that he could have made, and he was disappointed in that. Eric did not play real well tonight. He missed a lot. He 0 for 5 from the 3. I didn't feel like he defended real well. That's why I started Boogie in the second half. Boogie did a better job on defending, and then we had to switch our matchup, so we put Boogie on Shireman, and we ended up they put you in tough spots. You know, if you got guys out there, we had to put Goody on a guard, and he did okay on Easley, but obviously Mayo got away from him, and Mims made a 3 on him.
What's going to be the biggest adjustment then? You know, what's the biggest adjustment without Xavier again, assumedly Monday?
I think just getting guys back. If we can get guys back to practicing and you know, getting used to game. It may take a little while. We've had one game, as I said, in this period. Now we're going to play 3 games in the next 7 days. So we got to get the rust off quick. So.
With Sharman and Mayo, were they doing anything in particular, or were they just making shots?
They were taking advantage of some matchups. You know, as I said, we had our post player sometimes, whether it was transition or Mayo ended up with our Goody on him. And one time Tassos was on him. It's not a great matchup. Shireman, he's tough, you know, to guard for a lot of reasons. I mean, he's good with the ball. He can shoot it from deep. He's a very good passer. He's an exceptional player, and we didn't have the right – we were cross-matched a little bit. We had a post on him, so then we ended up taking our post and put it on either Easley or Mims to see if they could guard that. And then we put Boogie on Shireman. He did a pretty good job on him. I think just taking advantage of mismatches or cross matches, they do a really good job of that, and they're talented, and they're hard to guard, and they spread you out because they have so many shooters. So you've got to pick your poison. We didn't really do a very good job tonight of guarding them when they had the ball. The post was the biggest thing that I was, you know, you got to guard their post play. But I thought for the most part we did a pretty good job of that, but they got to the line a little more than we did.